Here's just a small little glimpse of my inside world. Here are my turtles, my lovely little turtles down there that we can kind of see playing. We have one here and one at the back. Yep, and they're quite happy. They've got plenty of room to swim and they get lots of live feed and that. But what I'm wanting to show you is just a very small little nutrient film technique, NFT system, that's on top where I'm just growing a little bit of basil and some coriander. So I've got the filter or the pump right at the back. I'm going to get bitten, I can feel it over here. And the water pumps up here and into this PVC pipe, which I've just cut holes out to slot these in. The water is only, is less than half full. And you can see I've balanced that out by where I have the holes coming out here. And water just flows across all the way down here and then, whoopsie, and then out and down. I have it angled in a way so that we can actually see that there is circulation in there. So if you're using a raft, or if you're using a raft will be used for what's called a deep water culture, so just floating polystyrene on top of things, or in this case the nutrient film technique NFT, as you take it out we can see the netting here. We've got some basil roots. How cool is that? Now a lot of people will use rock wool in here rather than the expander clay. It's just a cheaper, easier way of doing it. But if you do, you've got to make sure that you've got some type of filtration media, so some bio balls or something like that, to actually convert that ammonia into nitrite and then nitrate. I'm not sure if you can easily see, but there is a flow going from left to right from where the water comes in as it then flows across here. Now, we have dangling roots which live in there. Now, this is a very small little basil plant, very small compared to what you'll see outside. It's only a few weeks old. Now, can you imagine if we have a 6-foot tomato plant sitting in that? What's that going to do to the root space? Just root space to begin with. That's going to cause a problem. It's going to clog up. It's not going to be able to move water through. Therefore, it's going to flood over. Yeah, we don't want that happening. So whenever you're having something like this, make sure that you know what you're growing and how big the roots will grow. Okay? And second, while I have you, is if you've got a 6-foot tall tomato plant, which I do love growing, though I can't eat tomatoes. They make me quite unwell. So I love growing them though. But if I had a 6-foot one here, I mean, this is only 1 foot off from where it is. That is not going to hold or balance the tomato bush. You know how they branch out and they not only high, but they completely branch out wide. Something like that will not hold something as huge as a tomato plant or a corn plant, things like that. So if you're running a nutrient film technique, and this is a small one for a tiny little indoor little system, purely to keep my turtle's tank water, their water quality good. That's as simple as I'm doing. PVC piping, a net, and these are the hydroponic nets, so I do have them. I personally have some of the expander clay in there. You can use rock wool, but you do need to make sure you've got some type of filter media to convert all of that ammonia into nitrate. You can use this as like a coldness one, or your bio balls, things like that, but where the bacteria lives, which is awesome. But you can have it as simple as that, making sure that you have a light, one that is plant friendly. There's no point just popping any light on. This is a UV light for the turtles because they need it for their shells, but that will not provide the actual types of light that my plants need. So I did need to get a plant-specific light and globe. That is a very, very simple indoor aquaponics system. Pretty damn cool.
Well, thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you've got any questions or comments, make sure you do leave them below. And hit that subscribe button so you can find out when I've got more videos being posted. And don't forget to follow me on other social media, because I do different lives on different social media on different days. So, again, thank you for watching. I really value and appreciate your time, and I hope you enjoyed it.